Germany has taken the first steps that could lead to rationing gas, activating an emergency law designed to deal with energy shortages.
It comes after Moscow said it would demand payment for its commodities in rubles from what it called unfriendly countries. Well, Kingsmill Bond is an energy strategist at RMI, and he joins us now. Welcome to the programme. So, Germany on the point of introducing gas rationing, how significant would that be?
Very significant. In the short term, this is going to be extremely painful. We don't have a huge number of options in the short term. You have LNG and you've got rationing and you've got efficiency. But fortunately, in the long term, there are plenty of solutions really around renewables and efficiency. So we need to distinguish between the two. Short term, very difficult. Long term, there are proper solutions.
So if rationing did go ahead, what might it look like? Do you think we'd see households and businesses forced to shut everything down?
So what they've said is that they are going to protect households, they're going to protect hospitals and vulnerable areas of the economy. And there's no suggestion it's going to happen right now. It's just a preliminary and I think quite wise step in order to get the system ready for that potentially to take place. I mean, let's see, because there are plenty of solutions to this. There are negotiations going on. There may well be solutions in the short term.
Well, let's talk about these solutions then. If Russia's gas customers won't pay in rubles, if Russia does go ahead with this plan, what other options are there?
Well, the European Commission and the IEA have both set out a series of solutions to curtail Russian gas imports by the end of the year by two-thirds. So they include buying up to 50 BCM of LNG from other countries, which of course means that the global LNG price is going to be higher. It means that the problems being faced by Europe are going to become global problems faced by every other LNG importer. So that's one solution. And another solution is to speed up the deployment of renewables, so more solar and wind, and speed up the electrification of the European industry and heat systems with more heat pumps. And then the other solution is more efficiency. And of course, the final solution is behavioural change, turning down the temperature.
So price rises imminently then, but do you think we're looking at a long-term energy crunch?
Well, Russia is the world's largest producer, largest exporter of fossil fuels. Europe is Russia's largest customer. This is going to mean stress for a long period in the global energy system. And what that in turn will mean, inevitably, is that people will be searching for solutions. And of course, now we do have a solution in the form of renewables, which are 100 times bigger than fossil fuels. They're cheaper, they're everywhere. And I think what this is going to do is going to speed up the energy transition. And it means that peak fossil fuels, fortunately now, is behind us.
So as you say, Europe, a big customer of Russia. Can Russia afford to lose it as a gas customer? It makes roughly $800 million a day from selling gas to Europe.
Well, it depends which day you take it on. Between $400 and $800 million dollars a day, that is indeed true. No, it's going to be a massive problem for Russia. And that's why, in fact, it's highly likely that the two sides will come up with some kind of negotiated settlement in the short term. But again, as I say, the real problem for Russia is if you go to your biggest customer and start waving a large stick, then inevitably that customer is going to find other solutions. So the really interesting development in the last 24 hours is what Andrew Forrest has negotiated with Germany, which is the provision of Australian hydrogen to Germany from solar and wind sources in the Australian desert. This shameful war in Europe is kicking off a global energy revolution where hydrogen will now become eventually become the primary traded energy commodity.
So a move potentially to renewables and other fuels. Do you think the EU will be able to slash its consumption of Russian natural gas this year by the goal that it has, which is two-thirds? Is that even possible?
Well, of course it's possible if we have to. With all kinds of solutions as I just laid out, it can be done, but it will indeed be painful, not just, as I say, for Europe, but for China, for the world.